Hi. I messed this up. Hi, I'm David Dobrik, and this is Everything I Do in a Day. I wake up every day around 9 a.m.-ish. I say ish because I'm on my phone for like 45 minutes to an hour, just like on my phone going through social media, figuring out what I have to do. Before that, I have my first alarm kind of turn on around 6 a.m., and then in increments of 20 minutes, I have it ring because the last couple hours of sleep, I like to have it like just be interrupted. So it feels like I'm sleeping for longer. I don't know why, but I've been doing that for a while. After hitting snooze about 12 or 16 times, I go to the bathroom. First thing I do is I usually take a shower. I take a shower every morning. I brush my teeth in the shower, which I know is kind of weird. I shave. I do everything in the shower because I hate coming out and then doing stuff in the sink. I use Suave Kids shampoo, either Strawberry Splash or Watermelon Blast. I think it's Watermelon Blast. I've been using this shampoo for as long as I can remember. I used to use it because I used to take baths a lot, and it was the only shampoo that allowed me to go underwater because it said it was tear-free, which is actually tear-free. I didn't know. If it gets in your eyes, you're still crying after every shower session I have. This is so stupid. It's not so bizarre. I open my mouth and I let the water pour into my mouth. And I turn the shower off. And when I hear the final drops in the shower, I take the water and I spit it into my hand here and I let it drop on the ground. And I'm hoping that, this sounds nuts, and I'm hoping that the drop from my hand is louder than the last pieces of water that fell out of the shower. Does that make sense? I know this sounds absolutely insane, but I do this every time. And if I don't have the splash of water be loud, I have to redo the whole cycle and I have to turn the shower on. I know it sounds so, so stupid. I feel like a psychopath. And then when I get out of the shower, I take my toothbrush and my toothpaste and I put it back in the cup where it sits by the sink, so I have it for the nighttime. But instead of placing it there, I always like try to throw it in. And if I get it in, that to me, it means that I'm gonna have a good day. I know this all sounds crazy. I sound like a groundhog, like looking at my shadow and be like, oh. But that's kind of another thing I live by. Whew. I like to put my clothes on in the bathroom. Because I'm scared that I'm gonna come out naked and my friends are gonna be there with like a flamethrower or something to scare me. So I get completely ready in the bathroom, so when I come out, I'm camera ready just in case somebody's already filming me. When I'm done getting dressed, I usually go out to the living room around like 10:30, and I see Natalie there. Natalie's already had her morning workout. She's had three breakfasts, so she's ready to go. The morning is usually where I can tell how Natalie and I are gonna be the entire day. Natalie's my assistant and my friend, and usually like the first 5 minutes of the morning, I can tell if we're in a good mood and we're gonna like mesh well, or if we're just gonna go completely hate each other the entire day. I usually have tea to start out my mornings. I don't even really like the taste of tea, but I like holding something warm in my hand like this. And I walk around my pool table like a couple laps, and then I talk to Natalie and I ask her what we have to do. We usually have like one or two meetings to come to the house. So they're there around 11 to like noon. We'll have like one to three meetings. Different groups of people will come in. So maybe our merch company will come in, or someone with an app we're working on will come in, or just like some sort of brand we're working with will come in and we'll talk. It's really easy to do meetings at the house because it's my house, so it's super simple. We knock it out there. And then around noon, I usually call up all my friends and we kind of start the day and we try to find something fun to do. Usually it's just us sitting in the car for like 2 hours, just like bantering back and forth until we come up with a funny idea. And then sometimes when we have a funny idea, we'll go pursue it. Like maybe it's a trip to Vegas, or it's like a trip to Miami, or something spontaneous that we have to go do. And I love driving. Everywhere we go is 100%, like I have to be driving. I'm so uncomfortable in other people's cars. I cannot Uber. I'm like the guy that, like, when I had more time, I would love to pick up my friends from the airport. Like, I would get so mad at them when they would call an Uber, because I'd be like, I can be there. Like, let me just pick you up. I love driving. Most of my day is, I think, spent in my car, either driving around or going from house to house, seeing what people are doing. I go through all my friends and I text them individually, and I text all of them, what are you doing, what are you doing, what are you doing, what are you doing? And then I follow up if they don't respond in like 10 minutes of FaceTime, like, where are you? And then we usually get together And I'm super easy. I'll go wherever like my friends are going. So if they want to go, if like my friend says I need to go to Walgreens to pick up a prescription, I'm like, okay, I'm down. That could be, something funny could happen at Walgreens. So I usually just tag along with my friends. Sometimes we'll get an idea for like a celebrity friend to come by, and then we'll have to text them. And then it's just like an hour of us literally just, all my mind is thinking about is, will this person text back and will they be available to shoot within the next 30 minutes or not? A lot of the days are like all over the place because we're shooting completely different things every day. So no day is really the same. The moments from 12 p.m. to 4 p.m., especially in the winter, are super, super crucial because it's the only daylight we have. And then when nighttime hits, it's game over. So that's important. And then when the sun sets around like 4:35, I'll have a little bit of time where I'll be like, okay, let's go grab food real quick. Because there's like an hour in that time where nothing's really happening and people aren't getting ready to go out yet. What's tricky about my days is there can be a day that there's absolutely nothing going on and we are just like, everything we shoot is a complete bust and we shoot for like 4 or 5 hours that day and nothing happens, nothing is funny. But then there are also days that it's like every 30 minutes we have to be somewhere, like we have to, you know, make certain deadlines or we're not gonna make this flight or we're not gonna get to shoot with this person or we're like just chasing the sun. Like there's, every day is completely different. That's the best part I feel like about my days is, that's why I was so scared to do this video because I was like, what is my day? This should go without saying for me, but every second of every day, all I'm thinking about is making a new video. So every time I'm finished with a video, the next thing is how do I make the next one? And I'm out of ideas literally constantly, so it's just a nonstop cycle. I call my parents every day around 6 p.m. I say, I love you, Mom, I love you, Dad. They mean a lot to me. They get so mad at me when I don't call, so just keep that in, please. So around 6 o'clock, we start doing the podcast, and this can take anywhere from 45 minutes to like 3 hours sometimes because we get distracted a lot. And if something happens or we need to go film something, we'll just drop it and we'll pick it up another day because filming is always the most important priority. We finally wrap up the podcast. A couple of us go out to eat dinner, and then I usually go out and try to get some more stuff in the evening, just shoot some stuff outside. I usually go into In-N-Out because it's like the most nicely lit place in LA. The lighting inside is beautiful. If it's Monday, we're all at home, we're watching The Bachelor. Natalie and I usually have a fight about how the hell The Bachelor's even a thing because I'm confused how one guy can date 30 girls. It doesn't make any sense to me. And Natalie says it's cute. But then when one of our friends is talking to two different girls, she gets really mad at them. And then around 8 p.m., I think a couple of my friends start drinking. I don't drink, so I just kind of hang out. And then the rest of the night begins, and this is where it literally just becomes a roller coaster of things. And I get to bed around 3 or 4 a.m. And I know that sounds crazy. What the hell happened between 8 to 3, 4 a.m.? But I don't know, and I cannot explain it to you, and I will never be able to put it into words. But things happen. I'm usually home every day around midnight to 2 a.m. And then it's just a lot of hanging out at the house. My friends are usually at my house till 4, 5, 6 a.m. sometimes. Sometimes they sleep there. I don't really mind because I'm such a heavy sleeper. I'll just go into my room and just do my own thing while they're all be out and about in my living room having a blast. This is where I usually go, oh my God, I got nothing done today. And now I have to plan everything I'm gonna do tomorrow, like in the daylight especially because I wanna shoot a bunch of bits then. I go to my room at around 2 or 3. Before then, I have my late night snack, which is, I love watermelon and bread. I don't know what it is, but it's like putting watermelon on top of bread is like the best combination. I love moist bread. I don't know what it is. And then when I'm done eating, I take some water back to my room and I brush my teeth. I take out my contacts. Sometimes when I'm too lazy, I'll take out my contacts in bed and I'll just throw them on the floor, which is a serious waste because I have the 2 week ones. So when I'm throwing out the contacts, that's a big no-no. I like wearing a hoodie to bed because I like putting the hoodie over and then I like pulling the strings and like pretending I'm like in a really dark room. And I usually pull the covers over myself too and like put them under my neck so like I'm really trapped in there. I don't know, I like getting like really sweaty. I don't know why, but I like just being super warm and cozy. Yeah, and I love keeping the temperature up too. I have the temperature up at night at like 76 degrees and Natalie will always come down and turn it back down to like 68, which I think is crazy. I pray every night, I say the Our Father, it's pretty sweet. But every time I mess it up, I have to restart. And sometimes, this is so stupid, sometimes I'll mess it up like 4 or 5 times and I'll be praying for like a solid 4 or 5 minutes, but it's the same thing. But it's just like, I have to, in my head, I'm like, it doesn't go through if I don't get it in one go. So I have to start from the beginning. And then when I'm done with my 15 minutes of prayer, I lay down and I go to bed. I usually have nightmares. I'm like a nightmare guy. I have nightmares more than I dream, but I'm living the dream. And there you go. That's everything I do in a day. Kind of, from time to time. It's all different, but you get the point.